everybody, my name's Antoinette and this is Board Game Inquisition, where we absolutely love giving you insights and information about the board games you might want to have in your own collection. So are you in the mood for some absolutely adorable economic adventures? Well, if so, then here's five things I think you need to know about Raccoon Tycoon. In Raccoon Tycoon, you are attempting to make your fortunes in the bustling land of Astoria. On your turn, you can perform one of five actions. So firstly, you can play a card, so you alter the price of goods, and also produce goods for your own stockpile. Number two, you can buy a building tile to enhance your productivity. Three, you can sell goods for money. Four, you can start an auction on a railroad. And five, you can buy a town to enhance your railroad. The game ends once all railroads or towns have been purchased, and the winner is the person with the most victory points. Thing one, what's this game all about? Well, the setting for Raccoon Tycoon is an incredibly cute one, and it's one where you're trying to make money in this magical world of Astoria, which is inhabited by very cute and well-dressed creatures. The theme as a whole, though, isn't a terribly strong one. It's really more of a setting than anything else. But I would like to point out that economic games are normally set in kind of very rural settings or very industrial settings, and it's kind of refreshing to have somewhere else to do business that's kind of cute and fun and engaging. And I really like this setting. It made the game kind of very, very pleasant. So yeah, theme, not particularly strong, but I like it anyway. So, similar games to Raccoon Tycoon? Well, oddly enough, it feels quite similar to another title from Forbidden Games, and this is Railroad Rivals, which is a very pared-down economic game. But this game does have a very big cuteness factor, and sometimes it does remind me of Everdell. Thing 2, mechanics. So Raccoon Tycoon is really a game about hand management and about bidding. And on your turn, you're going to be using the cards in your hands to manipulate the price of goods and, of course, which goods you acquire at the same time. I'm a really big fan of these multi-use cards because one part of them is dedicated to manipulating prices and the other is dedicated to what items you're going to get. And it really cuts out a lot of the legwork for you as the player about deciding, you know, which goods you'd want to buy in a turn, because the cards limit these kind of options for you and they're often mixed together. So that basically, yeah, it saves you from doing a whole lot of mental arithmetic about which would be the best item to buy or sell at the moment. It narrows down your choices, and I'm a really big fan of that. The second part, I suppose, that's really important in this game is the bidding phase, and it's one where you're basically going up against your rivals. You start an auction so that you can acquire parts of the railroad. This involves set collections, so the more of the same types you get, the bigger the bonus. And this is definitely the most interactive part of the game, and it's the one that's rather cutthroat, and I think it's the part as well that brings out kind of the most strategy. In particular, at two players, this auction phase became incredibly important, and we would be watching each other's money totals to see how we could wrangle our way to get exactly the cards we wanted. I'm not normally a big fan of kind of auctions, but I think it works rather well here, and I can only imagine it being more cutthroat the more players you have. So don't let the cute kind of veneer on this game fool you. There's real stuff going on here behind all of that. There are also the building tiles, which I find particularly interesting because you can either spend your money on them to give you an improvement during the game, but you also need money to do other things with. And I still haven't decided whether they're worth investing your money in or not, but I do like that the option is there. Unusually enough for this game, money doesn't actually count for victory points at the end. Really weird, right? But this kind of twist encourages you to invest your money in the game while you are in fact playing. And I think that's actually kind of refreshing. It prevents people from just making money and sitting on a pile of it and doing nothing with it, and forces further interaction. Overall, this game is kind of laid back and easy to play, and the turns are quick and fast and fun, but it has its moments where it can be incredibly sharp. Thing 3, on the table. So Raccoon Tycoon is pretty tidy and neat when you set it up, and it's the type of game that you'll spot across from the room by virtue of its first player marker alone. It doesn't take long to set up and it's pretty easy to learn actually and to teach. For two of us to play, it's about 40 minutes. The turns are very quick though, and the rule book is very clear and concise. Now, replayability, well, this comes from the fact it's a market manipulation game, right? So every game's going to be a little bit different. But the addition of those building tiles really can change it up from game to game. Thing four, how does this game look and feel? Well, from the box art alone, I think you already know that you're in for a bit of a treat. It's these old, timey, adorable forest creatures. And I really, really love that combination. It's kind of the epitome of woodland chic. Now, the artwork as a whole is pretty stellar, but I do wish there was more of it in the game. But everything else that's in there fits quite nicely with this beautiful drawings and interpretations of kind of the world of Astoria. The component quality here is very, very good. Everything's very nicely made, but I do wish that the goods track was a little bit larger so you could fit the actual goods onto it. It can be difficult sometimes to tell what price your good is at. Overall though, this game is beautifully made. It's lovingly put together and I think it's one that anybody would be willing to sit down and play with you. Thing five, is this game actually any good? I'm going to come out of the gate and say Raccoon Tycoon really surprised me, because before even playing it, I'd heard good discussions about, you know, how good the gameplay was, you know, despite how cute and adorable it is. And so when I sat down to play it for the first time, I was straight up disappointed because it was just so much more simplistic than I had imagined or than the way, you know, people had talked about it. But it surprised me again because we played it two times, three times, more times, and I found us developing different strategies, using different parts of the games in different ways to interact with each other. And I was really, really impressed with the depth of tactics kind of and strategy that we came up with out of these very simple mechanics. And I think that is definitely the game's greatest strength. It comes up with these really interesting choices for gameplay out of the simplest ideas. But don't let all of that kind of fool you. This game isn't all gumdrops and roses. It'll definitely cut you. You are capable of making decisions that can ruin your game. There are wrong choices to be made that you can't recover from. And you really need to keep an eye on what your opponents are up to be able to make those kind of power bids. This is ruthless economics, no matter how nicely you dress it up. This is a pretty special game, and I definitely think it's one more people should be looking at. It's not just adorable, it's also incredibly smart. Do I think you should have Raccoon Tycoon in your collection? Well, I'm certainly going to be keeping it in mind, and it's definitely the sort of game you want to look at if you want something that's fun, cute, a bit cutthroat, and one where you're earning oodles of cash. You've been watching Board Game Inquisition. Why not like or subscribe to the channel so you can get updates about my future videos? Or if you've got any comments or queries you'd like to make about Raccoon Tycoon, why not shout them off in the comment box below? So tune in again next time for some more short and informative board game reviews.